level. I'm on a new level. Brought me a new shovel. Put these niggas in the dirt. Chain with the new bezel. All my niggas put a belt.
Yo, welcome into the New Level Podcast. I'm your host, Ask You Fitness, and this podcast was created to help those who lack motivation, accountability, consistency, and success on your own terms. So if you're the type of person that's inconsistent, you're always feeling drained, and you're never achieving your goals, this podcast is for you. Let's go. We're going to be talking about quitting because you feel drained. Quitting because you feel drained. Now, before we get into today's podcast, I want to give a huge shout out to one of my new listeners from Facebook, Mr. Caruth. He had gave a review and actually personally messaged me off of like what he felt in the message that he got across that I was sending across this podcast. I'm going to read it out to y'all, man. Man, I heard the podcast. All I can say is, wow, there's so much I can say, but too much to text. I'm blown away, primarily because this is always what I wanted to do, but I allowed everything to get in my way. But it seems like you didn't even consider anything negative and just went for it. It made me feel like there's still hope for me. Hope to push everything and everybody aside to get it done. That's what's up. That's what's up, man. I just wanted to give that shout out on the podcast because this is the exact reason why I create the podcast, guys. Like, this is the exact reason why I created it, because I once, you know, was in that place to where I was hesitant. I wasn't accomplishing my goals. I was stagnant. I just wasn't in the right mindset. And this wasn't too long ago. Like, we talking about a couple months ago, guys. Like, fitness did not solve everything for me. So I just want you to understand that right off the bat. All right. The second thing is, guys, I literally, like, the reason why I make this podcast and the reason I speak to you the way I speak to you is because I kind of put myself in the zone to where I'm like, I'm going to talk to the younger me to help me out, to actually like become a better person quicker. So I hope you all get some value from this podcast. I hope you take it away and you actually apply it, because there's no point in listening to it if you're not going to apply it. Okay. All right. So anyways, guys, we're going to get straight into today's podcast, which is quitting because you feel drained. Quitting because you feel tired. Quitting because you feel quote unquote lazy. Quitting because you work a 9-to-5. Quitting because you're a college student, you work a job, and you want your own success. But you're quitting because you're tired. You feel tired. Your life is busy. The first thing I'm going to be talking about in the podcast, I'm going to share a little story time with you all off of my own experience. The second thing we're going to talk about is over dedication versus lazy dedication. Third thing, guys, that we're going to talk about is actually how to solve both of these issues, how to solve over dedication and how to solve lazy dedication. Okay, so I'm going to explain both of those concepts in today's podcast. The first thing is, guys, story time. All right. So as you all may know, yeah, I'm consistent. I post a lot on social media. I go to the gym 5-6 days a week, and I've built that consistency, that momentum to actually do that over the series of years. OK, it didn't just come overnight. And I'm not speaking like, yo, like it's going to take forever. But it did take some trial and errors to actually ingrain that discipline in me, even when I don't feel motivated, to actually stay consistent in things that are going to bring me up and level me up in life. Okay, but there was a point in time in my life where I burnt out. I was over dedicated. I was to the point to where I was doing so much that I didn't want to do it anymore. The things I loved doing, the things that I had passion for, I didn't want to do it anymore. All right, and it wasn't the gym. All jokes aside, it wasn't the gym, I promise you that. It was literally creating content. At this point in my life, which was about a year and a half ago, I had 2 YouTubes, 2 Instagrams, 2 Twitters, 2 TikToks. I had 2 everything, 2 Facebooks, everything. I was trying to start a clothing brand. I was running Patreon. If you all don't know what Patreon is, it's like YouTube, but you don't have to wait for the subscribers to pay you. So it's like, it's kind of like OnlyFans. It's like you're paying for a subscription the second I drop a video. You get what I'm saying? Let alone, speaking of OnlyFans, I also created an OnlyFans for my fitness business, Ask You Fitness, as well. So I had about 9 different accounts, maybe 9 to 10 different accounts for these 2 businesses, guys. And I was consistent on them, but for a short amount of time. I had burnt myself out. I was over-dedicated. I want you to realize that you can also burn out when you're trying hard, when you're actually being consistent. But the concepts of over-dedication and lazy dedication are 2 separate things. It's like left Twix and right Twix. Over-dedication is the example that I just gave you, trying to be so successful, so hard, that you're overwhelming yourself. You don't give yourself a break, and you're doing so many things at once time that you literally get nothing done. You may pass time, you may pass 30 days, you may pass 60 days, 2 months of being consistent somewhere, but you're trying so many things at one time that you're never going to get anywhere. And that was the mistake that I had made. But before I teach you all like how to prevent yourself from over dedicating, let me knock down some folks that are going to like literally tell themselves, oh, I'm over dedicated. That's why I'm tired. No, like most people aren't over dedicated. And your excuses are only sounding good to you. See, they don't sound good to me. Even my excuses don't sound good to me. When I give myself an excuse, I'll say it because I'm not perfect. But at the same time, I think I'll be like, whoa, like, let me stop. Let me stop making excuses. Let me actually get something done. So guys, lazy dedication is exactly what you think it is. It's actually giving yourself leeway on what you can't do. Oh, well, it's 9 o'clock and let me go ahead and sleep right now. I do that tomorrow. I'm tired. I worked hard. Let me give myself a pat on the back. I worked hard. The biggest mistake that people do is going into work 8 to 9 hours for somebody else's dream to come true and you're not working on yourself. This doesn't mean that you have to have a business. This doesn't mean that you have to run a corporation. This means like stuff that you want to accomplish in your life. If you want to lose weight, if you want to gain weight, if you want to live more healthier, if you want to spend more time with family, anything that you would actually want to improve on, if you give your energy towards somebody else's dream and accomplishing their dreams, and you don't have energy to put into yourself and what you want out of life, that's lazy dedication. You're lazy. You are lazy. You look back, you give yourself a pat on the back just because you worked hard, and then you go and you repeat the same process, and then you wonder why you're still stuck in the same place until New Year's Eve comes and everybody write down what they want to accomplish. You feel what I'm saying? So what we have to do, guys, is hold ourselves accountable. The next time you feel tired, stop telling yourself you feel tired, man. Stop telling yourself you worked hard, because real hard work doesn't recognize it. Like, if you work hard, you're not gonna want to hear, oh, I worked hard. Like, you're gonna want to see the results. You get what I'm saying? So there's no point in the process of you grinding, of you putting forth your energy, there is no point for you to congratulate yourself and you haven't even done anything yet. You haven't even accomplished anything. You haven't even gotten that goal accomplished, and you're over here patting yourself on the back, oh, I worked hard today. You didn't even work towards your goal. Dabbling into over dedication and lazy dedication, guys, those are the two main differences when it comes down to actually never getting anything done. You can still be dedicated and consistent and still not get anything done. You're not going to be able to get anything done because you're actually trying too many things at the same time. And that is one of the biggest mistakes I made, guys, is just going all these different routes on all these different platforms and not having a productive plan to actually accomplish these goals that I set for myself. So the last thing that we're going to talk about in today's podcast, guys, is how to solve both of these issues. If you're the type of person who's over dedicated, and by over dedicated, I mean you're trying so many things at the same time, you're trying to do, I'm gonna just name my instances. It's gonna be a lot easier for me to just say my examples. But if you're trying to do 2 TikToks, 2 YouTubes, 2 Instagrams, 2 Facebooks, 2 Twitters, you got OnlyFans, not because of that reason, but because, you know, I was making fitness videos, and you got Patreon, like all these different platforms, and you're trying to like move at a consistent pace and be productive. If you're trying too many things and you're not giving yourself a break, you're not going to be productive. You're going to burn yourself out. You're going to lose the motivation for actually getting the goal accomplished, and you're just never going to get it done. You feel what I'm saying? You're going to actually never get it done. Now, lazy dedication is a little bit different. Lazy dedication, most people don't like to be called lazy. They like to feel like they work hard. So you go and work for somebody else, and you come back, and when it comes down to your goals, you complain on how tired you are. And you never get it done because you push it to the next day. Oh, I'm busy. No, you're not busy. You're disorganized. Scrolling on Facebook, on Instagram. You don't look at how long you're holding a conversation on FaceTime. Like it's time to get to work. That is the main difference between over dedication and lazy dedication. So now we're going to talk about the solutions. Over dedication. There's 2 solutions on how to solve over dedication. And I'm speaking from my own experience. So make sure that you listen closely and you apply this. Okay, that's the most important part. Don't just listen, apply it, all right? The first way to solve the problem of over-dedication is to have a daily schedule of small tasks towards your goals. Guys, this is the biggest, one of the biggest things that's helped me actually become productive. I'm talking about goals that I've set for myself that I didn't think I would accomplish in a year. I was accomplishing in 2 to 3 months, literally, with the right plan. I had the drive. I had the motivation, right? I didn't have the right technique. It's like a football player training for football, and you put him on a basketball court. Like, he's not going to have the right technique. He's not going to know the right drills. So at the end of the day, you're not being productive. You have to have a schedule. You cannot get everything done in one day. I always thought I could get everything done and when everything that I needed to be completed in a week, I thought I could do it in a day because I work hard, right? I'm motivated, right? I'm driven, right? No, I got burnt out. I looked at what I was doing and I was like, man, this is depressing. I felt like I was trapped in a box. You feel what I'm saying? The second way, guys, to get over and solve the problem of overdedication is to know that the work will never be complete. It is a journey. Like I said, you don't have to have a business. But if you're on a journey, a fitness journey, being responsible and accountable journey, a lot of people have the mindset of, oh, I'm going to do this for this long and I'm going to get better. But how long is it going to last? How long do I have to do it? You need to get rid of that question immediately. You need to get rid of the question of how long is it going to take? It's going to take forever because it's a journey. And the second that you let up from that good trait, the second that you let up from holding yourself accountable, the second that you let up from being consistent, there goes your progress, there goes your momentum. So you need to understand it's never going to be over. It is a journey, guys. Lazy dedication solutions, we got three of them. The first one is realize that you will always be in that position until you put in the work, until you put in the necessary amount of work, unless you win the lottery, okay? But most of us ain't gonna win the lottery. So in order for you to accomplish a goal, you got to realize and face yourself, look yourself in the mirror and say, look, this is never going to get done until I put in this amount of work, because you're not putting forth the amount of effort that is needed for you to accomplish that goal. It's almost like a weight loss client wanting to lose 50 pounds and they eating 6 cheat meals a week and you eating healthy one day. Like, you know how long that's going to take you? First of all, you ain't going to get nowhere. But that's just to give you an example that if you don't put in the optimum amount of work, stop putting in the bare minimum, because the bare minimum ain't going to get you no results. It's not going to get you no results, all right? The second way, guys, to solve lazy dedication is to ask questions and advice from those who you want to be like. Do not let your ego get in the way. Study people who you want to be like. Don't take advice from people who are not in the position that you want to be in. Don't take advice from people who have bad characteristics of responsibility, of accountability. If they're not on their stuff, why would you ask them a question about you becoming a greater person within? It's just never going to get you there. It's never going to get you there. And I'm going to open up to y'all a little bit, man. Like, I had to buy a mentor. I had to buy, not buy, but I had to hire, you know, some mentors to help me be a better content creator. Because I felt stuck. Because I wasn't moving anywhere. Because I was the person who was feeling lazy. I was the person who felt like giving up. I wasn't seeing the results. But those mentors that I hired, right? Those people that I asked advice from, they had given me the blueprint to get that success I wanted. And then what I did was I used all that drive, all that energy that I was spending on trying to keep myself busy and successful. I applied it to what they gave me. And that's when my success started to blow. That's when I actually started to see the results. You feel what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, guys, you got to start asking people for advice. Don't let your ego get in the way. I feel like a lot of guys out here, you know, they'll want to build muscle. Or they want to lose weight, but they don't want to reach out to somebody that can actually help them. You know, we got a lot of access to information these days. You can go on YouTube. You guys, it's so many resources that you can use, and I'm not knocking that, but I'm just saying, like, at a certain point, if you want to reach a certain goal, I don't care if it's not even about fitness. Like, if you want to reach a certain goal, you got to ask somebody, man. All this ego-driven stuff in today's society, talking about self-made, they're not self-made. They got help from somebody else. And they take their egos and blow themselves up, calling themselves self-made. No, you had help. You had some type of guidance, bro. You feel what I'm saying? That's why it's not that many successful people. Because people don't ask. But then when people get successful, they want to call themselves self-made. That influences you to be like, oh, well, I got to do it on my own. No, you don't. I promise you. Hey, look, you can do it on your own. But you know how long it's going to take you? Cut yourself hard times, because it's going to be hard anyways. Cut yourself some hard times, man, and just ask somebody. All right, the third way to get rid of lazy dedication, that's a tongue twister for me for some reason, is to stop making excuses. Stop making excuses. Like I said earlier, your excuses only sound good to you, not me. Maybe your friend, because your friend is going to tell you stuff that you don't need to hear. And what I mean by that is your friend is going to tell you stuff that you want to hear. Your friend ain't going to try to offend you. But you need someone or yourself to tell you the things that you don't want to hear. Like, yo, like, oh, it's not working? Okay, try harder. Try a different route. Start from scratch again. You may not want to, but guess what? Do you want to be stuck in the same place for the rest of your life? Because if you do, hey, go ahead. Go ahead, keep on making them excuses. You get what I'm saying? So that's the three ways, guys, to get rid of lazy dedication. All right? If you are over-dedicated, you need to have a daily schedule with small tasks towards your goals every single day to accomplish those bigger goals. The second way, guys, to solve over-dedication is to know that the work will never be complete. So do not try to overwork yourself. Do not try to get everything done in one day. All right? Have a set plan. For my lazy, dedicated people, realize that you will always be in that position until you put in the work. Can't nobody else make it for you, bro. Can't nobody else make you do the work. So you have to be the one to put in the work. The second way, guys, to get rid of lazy dedication is to ask questions and advice from those that you want to be like. Too many times, guys, we feel that we're entitled to a certain opinion. So when we want help, we just ask anybody. Like if you really want to move forward in life, you have to ask the people who you want to be like. Because they can teach you. They've already been on that road that you were already on, that you're going on. All right? Troy said, Rome wasn't built in a day. Bro, I was going to say that too. I was going to say that early in the podcast. I had forgot that quote, man. But that's facts. That's facts, bro. And guys, the last way to get rid of lazy dedication is to stop making excuses for yourself. Like sometimes we can even say excuses and we think it's so good. We blame other things and other circumstances as to why we can't accomplish our success and get where we want to get. But you know what? Every time that you create an excuse, you give that item, that person, that situation power over what you can actually become. We don't like obstacles, but excuses are created obstacles. Okay? That is why when you tell your excuse to somebody who doesn't put up with excuses, it doesn't sound good because it was created in your head, in your conscience. All right? Guys, I hope you all got value from today's podcast. If you're ready to get your body right, if you're ready to get shredded, you get toned, you're ready to get fit, lose weight, or gain muscle, make sure to follow me on Instagram. Hit me up at AskYouFitness on all platforms, all right? You know what we do? We keep grinding. We keep getting 1% better each and every single day. I'm out.